Welcome to Kishore's Neat Padasala. In this video, we will see the concept of Archimedes' principle. In NCERT, it is a very small box given, but for exam, you want to know how you want to apply the formula for different cases. Okay, Archimedes' principle states that the loss of weight of a fully or partially submerged body in a fluid is equal to the weight of fluid displaced. So, suppose there is a water here in which you are submerging a body. Okay, due to the submerging body, the water outflows. The loss in weight of this circular body, is equal to the weight of fluid displaced. Actually, this is the statement of Archimedes' principle. Okay. Now let us see for the competitive exam point of view. Okay, what are all the points you must remember? I will say the apparent weight of a floating body is zero. This is a very important point, and this is a line given in NCERT, the blue color box. The apparent weight of a floating body. Okay, remember that for a fully floating body is zero. Then apparent weight formula, let us see. Okay, suppose here we are taking a liquid and we are dipping a box. The liquid density is rho and the box density or the solid density is sigma. Then apparent weight W dash is equal to initial weight of the block into 1 minus sigma by rho, where sigma is the block density and fluid density is rho. This is the formula you must remember. Okay, W dash is equal to W into 1 minus block density by fluid density. Now let us see another exam point of view. This is the formula given in NCERT. So in NEET exam, only based on this formula they will ask exam, I can guarantee you. Okay, suppose let us assume a setup like this. Total volume of solid floating. Okay, what is the volume of this block? Let it be V. Volume inside the water. Okay, this volume inside the water is V in. Density of solid, let it be rho s. Density of liquid, that is here in this case it is water, let it be rho w. The formula you must remember is volume of full solid, okay, into density of solid into acceleration due to gravity is equal to volume of solid inside the fluid into density of fluid into acceleration due to gravity. So this formula you must remember: volume of the whole solid into density of whole solid into acceleration due to gravity is equal to volume of solid inside the water into density of water or fluid into g. This formula is alone you remember, which is nothing but the buoyant force. This is the formula you must remember. It is enough for NEET, as only this formula is given in NCERT. This is the buoyant force. Now let us work out a numerical. The density of ice is 0.9 gram per centimeter cube. What percentage volume of block of ice floats outside the water? Draw the diagram. Okay, this is a water of density floats outside the water they have given. So density of water in with respect to centimeter cube we want to do. So with respect to density of water is in centimeter cube, gram per centimeter cube. So it is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Okay, density of water in kg per meter cube is 1000 kg per meter cube. Okay, so with respect to gram, it is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Next, ice is there. Okay, the density of the ice, that is density of solid, is 0.9 centimeter gram per centimeter cube. So what volume of ice float outside the water? What we have formula and we have learned, volume of solid into density of solid into g is equal to volume of solid inside the water into density of fluid into g. So volume of solid, total solid is Vs into density of solid is 0.9 into g, and g get cancelled. Okay, so is equal to V in into rho w is 1. So, volume of V in by Vs is equal to 0.9 divided by 1. Okay, so which is 9 by 10. Okay, so V in by Vs is, okay, we are multiplying it by 100, which is percentage of ice inside the water, which is 90%. So 90% is inside the water. In the question they are asked, outside the water how much solid is there? It is 100 minus 90, which is 10%. So 10% of the ice is outside the water. Now let us work out this numerical. There is one block in which two fluids, this is one fluid, this is another another thing. Okay, here the cube, in the downside it is A and here it is B. What is the mass of this cube they are asking? Okay, mass of the cube is mg is equal to density of A into volume of A into g plus density of B part of the cube into volume of B part of the cube into g. See here that relative density of A is 0.6. So relative density of A is 0.6. So density of A is, so relative density is density divided by 1000, which implies density is equal to 0.6 into 1000, which is 600. So relative density of B, similarly it is 400. Okay, now let us work out what is the density of A. They have given density of A is, we found it as a 600. So 600 into volume of A, it is length into base into height. For A part, the two lengths are 10 centimeter into 10 centimeter into height is 4 centimeters. So 4 into 10 power minus 2 into acceleration due to gravity is 10 plus the density of second part of the cube, which is 400 into volume of cube is two length are 10 centimeters. So 10 into 10 power minus 2 into 10 into 10 power minus 2, centimeter is converted to meter, into the height is 6 centimeter into 10 power minus 2. So volume is length into base into height into, so acceleration due to gravity is 10. If you work out, the answer comes out to be 4.8 kg. okay, 4.8 kg, but 4.8 kg, but you want to convert it in, suppose if you are converting it into grams, then 4.8 into 1000, which is 480 gram. So this is the mass of the cube. I hope you like this lecture. If you like this lecture, please subscribe Kishore's Neat Paathshala. Thank you.